Okay, welcome back to more Let's Play Bahamut Lagoon Blind. Hopefully this will be the fucking finale. In the last one, we killed off the other heads and did not quite finish off this one. If you haven't noticed by him being alive still. Alright. I mean, I've been wailing on him for a while. I predict that we will be able to see his HP very soon. Possibly, like, any one of these attacks could be the one. 2,400, golly. I know it's already gonna do 2,400 when I do it, but still, like, man. I'm still like, oh my gosh, so much damages. Oh my gosh, that must have been a crit hit. Fucking Lancer dude finally did 1,000, man. I'm not taking back what I said about them being worthless. He's still fucking worthless as shit. Just because you do 1,000 damage one time doesn't make you suddenly, like, I'm not gonna take back all the shit I said about Lancers being useless. Sorry, son, that's not how it works. Okay, that was actually nice, and I got that heal. And Dahomey Yosh needed it, too. Alright, Q. Oh my gosh. Okay, I thought that was gonna be the one. Alright, this is the one. Hail Satan! Hail Satan! Hail Satan! Hail Satan! It's your Tenacious D joke for the day. Oh man, Tenacious D. Actually, I didn't know that. They're coming out with a new album. And I pre-ordered that shit. Well, actually, I pre-ordered it by, like, putting it in my, like, cart, but haven't, like, I haven't purchased the pre-order yet or whatever. You know what I mean? But I saw him on an episode of, I don't know how the hell, like, YouTube apparently, like, knows what I like to watch very well somehow. What the hell was that? Small amount of sleet? Is that what that attack was? But, it was Tenacious D eating, like, hot, like, they would put, like, hot sauce on, like, chicken wings, and they'd start with, like a regular sorta not really that hot one, and then they, like, gradually move up to hotter and hotter ones. And then they just, like, a dude's, like, interviewing them, and they interview it while their mouth fucking burns off. And, holy shit, boy, I hadn't seen or heard anything from them in a long time. And, yeah, apparently they are making a new album, so it's pretty cute. And, man, I hadn't even seen them. I haven't seen, like, what they look like in a while. Kyle Gass, fucking, he looks exactly the same, except his hair is, like, pitch white. Like, white, like paper white. And, Jack Black's, he's got, like, tons of facial hair, and, like, parts of it are white. And, yeah, he fucking... Oh, shit, what the... Did he just heal? Oh, we can see his life. All right, sweet. And, Jack Black is getting fat, man. It's a little bit sad. Just because when people get fat like that, they die premature deaths. And I don't want him to die, man. So I get a little bit saddened. Oh, goddammit. He should be dead pretty soon. Let's just attack. I thought Gunso and Barkley had almost the same amount of SP, so how did one run out two attacks before the other guy? I have no idea. But Jack Black's getting fat, man. He's fat. Kyle Gass was already, like, the fatter of the two. And Jack Black's catching up with him. I mean, like, Jack Black was always kind of, like, chubby. He was always, like, I don't know, 40 pounds overweight. But, man, he's straight up fat ass now. And then, like, his face is, like, getting, like, oh shit, ripped my headphones off. Actually, I haven't done that in a while. I did the thing where I, like, moved my head down and it got caught on the cord and it, like, yanked it off. And it, like, stretched out the little adjustable thing, like, all the way. So I had to push them jams back in. But, like, when you get, like, old and fat at the same time, like, man. Actually, Jack Black's face, he's starting to kind of look like Michael Moore, actually. Which is not a good look for Jack Black, I gotta say. Luckily they're both still, like, funny and stuff, though, so. Alright. Get it over with. So is he just, like... I don't know what the fucking word is. Is he actually summoning Valatora to attack us? Or is it, like, the essence of Valatora or some shit? Because I thought we were in control of those four dragons, or five, or whatever. Five dragons, or whatever. So, like, how is he able to use the dragons against us, I wonder? no idea. Actually, okay. Let's just heal, right, Shmia. Alright, heal it up, heal it up. Pretty sure we should be able to kill him this turn. That would be nice. Is he gonna heal too? Alright, sweet. Good boy. Yeah, the dragons would have been fine. Yeah, it was just Madelite's party that needed the heal, but I guess if the other dragons get hit with the heal too, I guess that works. Actually, only one of them needed it. Oh shit, 2,000. Oh, dude, we still got this. This is it. We're gonna do it. We're gonna attack the shit out of your mouth, man. Oh, man. Gonna inspire him to death. Does this even do damage to him? It does. I thought that it didn't do... I thought that, like, in the last fight, I did Terra Break from the field, and it didn't do anything, I thought. Alright, anyway, we got him. Woohoo. That was actually not very challenging. But I gotta say, that is a really super sweet, badass-looking sprite. Holy shit. I also like the close-up of the dragon, of Alexander's face in the other form or whatever. It's pretty badass, too. It was kind of weird that it was just the head. What shall we do? Alexander is about to revive again. Oh yeah, we get to find out what Miss Yo-Yo is gonna do. It's okay, leave it to me. Is she gonna take the spirit of Alexander into her body and then, like, kill herself or something? Yo-Yo, is she gonna die? Palpelios! Be like, take me one more time, because otherwise I'll be dead next time you get the chance to fuck me. Friends from Orlis, everyone give me your power, give me strength! Oh man, she's gonna summon the spirit bomb! Thomas, please, you too! Why should I give you anything? Why don't you go get everything you need from Palpelios? He's the one that you got the fucking hots for. Why don't you go... He's the one that makes your vagina all moist and juicy, so why don't you just get all your shit from him, man? You don't like me, Thomas. I make you feel awkward when I'm with you. I understand that. Well then, don't fucking... Never mind. But Thomas, you really are an important person to me. Oh, I like you like my best friend and also brother. Without you, I wouldn't be here. You taught me something important. The feeling of reaching beyond the sky, that there really is such a feeling. But I still want to fuck Palpelios, despite all the shit that you did. It's like, why did I give you anything if I wasn't going to get fucking vagina in return? Just this once, give me strength like you did then. No, I need my blowjobs up front before I give a woman anything these days. Sorry. Sorry, not sorry. Thomas, thanks. Wait, did I do it? Oh my god. Hey, Thomas, do you mind if I hold on tight? Zip. It's awkward, let go. If I say go ahead, it's gonna make me sound like I'm, like, needy and shit. No, don't. Already grabbed on. That is unwanted. That is sexual assault for you to grab my penis without my consent. Dragon King Alexander, come into my mind. I'm not afraid of you. Because I have all my friends here. They will all give me strength. Alexander, come. All right, you ask for it. Here it comes. Who the hell are all those guys? Oh man. Oh man. He's gonna bust a huge load ever. Look, the whole screen's turning white. He just like soaked us all. He just bukkake'd like all of us. What happened? Is Alexander inside the princess? Ooh. Bom chicka wow wow. Then have the holy dragons begun to fight inside her? Somebody do something. Yo-yo, yo-yo! Well, I sounded like a thug for a second. Yo-yo, yo-yo! Oh, Dragonite, hurry and do something! What? What do you expect him to do? He just walked up. Do something! He's like, what? I just showed up. I was just in the bathroom. What the fuck? She's a strong girl. She's done very well. She will be alright now. Yeah, she's a strong, independent woman. She don't need no Dragonite. Come forth, Valitora. Okay. You're just farting out dragons? What the hell? Okay, so Valator went into that dude, I guess. Where did he go? Leviathan, okay. Why is this happening again? Or why is it... I meant to say, like, why is this happening again? I'm not sure. Looks like he's eating his own tail. Do we have to get rid of the other dragons to make room for Alexander or some shit? If all the dragons leave Yo-Yo's body, then there won't be anybody to fight Alexander inside of... Alexander, or inside of Yo-Yo, I think, right? Why are the dragons leaving Yo-Yo and going into the Dragonites? I don't understand. Yo-Yo's gonna be killed, isn't she? I have a feeling they're gonna be like, oh, the only way to kill Alexander is to kill me. But then wouldn't the spirit just leave again? To go into someone else? Okay, you can walk a little faster. We don't have all freaking day, man. Why do they keep disappearing? Shouldn't they be, like, turning into the dragons? The time for revival has come, Bahamut! So how did you get elected to be the one to have, like, Bahamut, the best one? Do they, like, just draw straws or some shit? Like, ah, you suck, you got Garuda, the shittiest one. That has, like, diddly dick for attack range. What about Alexander? It would seem that these are the last surviving Dragonites. Alexander resides inside the girl, however the battle has ended. What is inside her is the anger and hatred of Alexander. And his sadness, perhaps. I thought Alexander was like the holy dragon, or the holy something or other, in the Final Fantasy games. Anytime you summon Alexander, it's always like a holy attack, right? I thought. Then what will happen to Yo-Yo? Please don't worry, I seem to be fine. Yes, I'm alright. No, really. I'm not possessed by Alexander. You see, I'm not the weak-minded princess I used to be. I'm the Queen of Karna, and a Dragonar. Having Alexander inside my mind is nothing to me. So you just got strong because reasons? You're just okay with it now? It doesn't bother you? Bahamut, Bahamut, Guardian Dragon of Karna. From now on, what will? Wait, why didn't that Dragonite disappear? I've just been revived. I'm unable to see into tomorrow. What should I say? Just talk out your ass like I do when I make these videos. Jeez. I was once inside you. I am able to read your mind. Holy shit, that never works when I do it. Your anger and fear towards us, your happiness and sadness. Listen, Dragnar, allies of the Dragnar. Orlis waits, return your world. Okay, why? Like, just remember who gives you the hot D. Oh my gosh. Poor Thomas. Inside Yo-Yo's heart, you are held very dear. Dude, if she ain't putting out for me, she ain't holding me that goddamn dear. However, those are her memories of you. They're merely memories that shall someday fade away. Thomas, the new eras come, but new eras soon become old ones. No one can escape the flow of time. Listen well, Thomas. Look only to the future. You live only here in the present, which continues to forward advance unabated. I technically don't know what the word unabated means. Come on, Thomas. Let's go home. But first, there's something I need to say to you. Thank you, Thomas. It's been so long since I've used those words. It feels so awkward. Yeah, nothing makes a situation more awkward than, like, announcing that it's awkward, right? Okay, Thomas, how should we act when we return to the others? How should we act? Just be your fucking goddamn selves. I don't know. Fighting spirit. Does it even matter? Like, yeah, we're fighters. And the lovebird's up in the corner. I'm surprised Madelite's like, well, since Yo-Yo's out of the picture, do you think we could maybe experiment a little bit? You know, I mean, I do think you're a pretty handsome fella, if you know what I'm saying. Oh. Oh, so the door was just the sky, like, opening. I thought we saw, like, a... I thought there was, like a circular portal or something that we went through. Maybe not. I don't know. That was a long time ago. Thomas, are you really giving this house to us? Oh, fuck no, man. Madelite told us about it. Is it true? Wait, so he told you... Someone told you that I would give them the house, and you just believed them? What the fuck? This sure brings back memories. When you think about it, this house was at the beginning of it all. Oh, excuse me. Taicho, Zora, lots of people escaped the war and gathered here. Oh yeah, Zora, the person that had, like, zero important lines in the whole game. We, until we met you, Thomas, we were like stray dogs. But? What do you mean, but? It's nothing. Bickabocker. Nothing, it's just... I was just wondering if we've become adults. Oh my gosh. If you're wondering if you became adults, then you're probably not an adult. An adult. Then I remember the fun times and the difficult times. It is weird to think that, like, we're considered adults when we're 18, but then, like, when you get into your 30s, you think back at how you were when you were 18, you're just like, God damn. I was just a dumb little shit that could buy cigarettes and porn. That was all I was. Stop it. Don't say things like that. You're gonna start crying. But I've been holding back all my tears all this time. I mean, there's nothing wrong with being a dude and crying, but, like, Jesus Christ. Fucking at least have the fucking politeness to, like, do it, like, by yourself, so other people... It's fucking weird when someone's, like, crying in your presence. But then, like, it's, like, they're sad about something that you're not sad about, so you're just like, oh, this is weird, should I just... I want to comfort them, I guess, but also want to give them space and just let them be sad, I guess? Sometimes when people are crying, they just want to be, like, left alone. So then it's, like, super goddamn awkward when someone's crying and, like, in front of you, and you're just like, I don't know what to do, should I just leave? It's finally been decided. Decided? Do you perchance mean the new king of Mahal has been decided? Yeah, listen, don't be surprised now. Who, you don't mean... I, the pure-hearted and serious Don fan? Wow. I never thought that a person would describe themselves as serious when they're trying to talk themselves up. No, it's Taicho. Taicho's the king. Really? Yeah, it's like he finally gave in to Gunso's persuasion. Ahaha, tis just like Taicho to be unable to say no to a person's request. Okay, let's go to Mahal Palace. Jian is waiting too. So if he's gonna cave into peer pressure, what kind of, like, how good of a king could he possibly be? You need to be able to, like, stand your ground and make important decisions. Because you gotta keep in mind that, like, when you're the king, like, every decision is gonna have... Like, it's going to have benefits, but, like, anytime you do something, it's always going to have negative effects, too. So you have to, like, decide what's best. You can't just be like, whoever can persuade me the best, that's who I'll listen to. It's like, you're supposed to be the king, man. You're supposed to make decisions based on, like, your own shit instead of what people convince you to do. Because you're the only one I can think of as being the new king, Taicho. I'm a man who could not protect Mahal long ago. I'm not certain if everyone will agree or not. Well, you're the king, so it doesn't matter if they agree or not. What are you talking about, Taicho? You will always be our leader. Trying to do the Jedi mind trick on him? What the hell? I'm truly glad I have followed you this far. I think so, too. The pure-hearted and serious Don fan also thinks so. Goddamn, dude. If it slips once, that's fine, but now you did it twice? Everyone... Souser! Oh man, he dead. It's over, all of it. The legend we dreamed of, it is all ended. But you're no longer here, Souser. What you saw wasn't really war, it was peace, wasn't it? I get that feeling, Souser. Goodbye, Souser. But I thought Souser was bad. I guess they did have that scene where he's like, I'm actually not as bad as you originally thought. I don't remember it, though. Yo-Yo, I will stay by myself in Grand Bellows. Even though the war has ended, I cannot show my face in Kana, forgive me. Okay, yeah, he knows that he did some effed up shit. However, you have excellent friends. You aren't lonely, are you? I envy you, Yo-Yo. Why doesn't he just have Yo-Yo come live with him? Goodbye, Legend of the Holy Dragons. Did you just say goodbye to a legend? Palpelios, you're the one who got us all into that damn war. So you're gonna take so how are you gonna take responsibility for it? So that you are satisfied, do as you wish. Shit, trying to show off, huh? This knife will take care of that. So he's actually, like, allowing them to stab him? Alright. Ah! Oh. I thought that was dude saying that. Like, yeah, that's what everybody says when they get stabbed. Oh, it's gonna be like, Yo-Yo's gonna be like, I had a dream that something bad happened to Palpelios. Queen Yo-Yo, what's the matter? I just over-exaggerated, it's nothing. I had a sudden chill, that's all. Pretty sure that's not, like, a real thing. Where is Madelite? He is mumbling to himself in front of the throne. Again, as usual. Uh-oh. Somebody better go get him his tapioca and give him a sponge bath or something. He needs to be taken care of. He needs someone to change his diaper and look after him. Again, he's been doing that every day, ever since we returned to Kana. Your Majesty, Yo-Yo has become very strong. Do not worry about Kana. As long as I, Madelite, am here, and as long as they are here. Who are you talking to? There's nobody in the throne, man. Thomas, has become an extravagant man. Uh-oh. I think Madelite does have the hots for Thomas. I'm happy to have such good friends. Who will be willing to experiment with me and maybe just do like a hand job with me wearing like a fucking latex glove? Is it gay if you jack off another dude with a latex glove on your hand? Maybe it's only gay for him. Maybe it's gay for like the receiver of the hand job. But then if the other person wore a condom, then that's like two barriers to like protect you from the gayness, right? Before long, the countless lagoons throughout Orlis had adopted a peace treaty and became a single kingdom. Thomas, former captor of Kana's Dragon Squad, was given the duty of watching over the skies of all lagoons. Oh jeez, no pressure. That's a lot of shit to watch over for one person, goddamn. Together with that dragon of legend. Which one? That dragon? Which one was that? Which one is that one? There were several of that ones. The legend of the Holy Dragons. It all began with a single man who rose to challenge it. Rose to challenge the legend? War of Betrayal, the legend of the Holy Dragons. Okay, Holy Dragons, we get it. Jeez. How could they be holy if they were all, like angry and shit for, like, a good part of the game? Oh, shit. I had my head turned. I didn't see what that said until it was fading away. Was it... what was the new era? Freedom, perhaps? Or maybe peace? Yeah, peace and freedom typically go hand in hand, for the most part. We who cannot see into tomorrow have no way of knowing, but... But, you already said that. If you don't find dreams yourself, if you don't capture your ambitions, happiness won't just come to you. You shouldn't... cry so much that you cry even when you get hungry? Is that what that said? Living is actually a very difficult thing. Living in quotes? Even if it's just a little bit, I feel I understand that now. This ending took kind of a wishy-washy turn, man. I don't know if wishy-washy is the correct phrase, but you know what I mean. The Holy Dragon Bahamut chose not to return to Altair and remained in Orlis. To ensure that war does not occur again, and oh my gosh. I thought Bahamut was from Orlis. How much time has passed since then? Dude, I don't fucking know. Since our world came to be called... Don't say it. Oh, okay. Bahamut Lagoon, okay, fine. I thought he was going to just say Orlis. So they did the thing. They said the title of the game in the game. When did it become Bahamut Lagoon? What would that even mean, though? I thought the world was called Orlis, so why are they saying that it's Bahamut Lagoon? But the little jammy dudes right there, the little square things, they look like they're just like pasted on or whatever. Okay, so we got battle event, dragon grow, and tool making. Maybe that was a weird translation. Oh, it's kind of a cool scene. I don't know what it's showing, but I like the purple and the red with the. I'm guessing that's a moon. But we got credits. Woohoo! So we fucking did it. Did that say super effect? Oh yeah, the fucking part with all the weird goofy rainbows that don't quite connect with each other. What the hell were those supposed to be? Why did that pass the this is fine test? Okay, so yeah, we are finally done with this game. Woohoo. This is now, as is tradition, this is the part where I go, okay, you're supposed to do final thoughts, but then I never know what to say because I always, I talk about my feelings for the game throughout the game. So, I guess I could go over it in case people skipped, like, all the episodes and just watched the finale. Sometimes people just watch the finale. Basically, I already said that I think that parts of the game were, it was lengthened too much. Like, fights that didn't seem to be that important but still took an hour to play, you know? And then we fought a boss character that had nothing to do with the story, you know? And, so yeah, it seemed like a lot of the stuff was just, seemed like there was a lot of just, like, filler. I mean, I know it's an RPG and you gotta make the game, like, long and stuff, but, I guess there wasn't any grinding. I never had to grind at those bonus dungeons, but, goddamn, like, we're already at the end screen. Okay, so basically, the difficulty, I don't think, was very high. I wish that you could have, skipped the enemy phases, or, like, sped them up. Do it at, like, times two speed or something, I don't know. Like, it didn't give you the option to skip the enemy animations or whatever. At the same time, like I said, that did give me an opportunity to talk about other shit besides just staying on topic of the game or whatever, just talking about the shit related to the game. And I kind of wish that there was a better in-game explanation about what some of the stats did. I didn't know what some of the stats did. And you don't learn spells by, like, leveling up. Which spells you have, it's affected by which dragon you have assigned to them. Okay, back to the starting screen, I suppose. And also, I didn't understand, like, what's the point of leveling up if you don't ever need to grind? You level up, but then, like, the difficulty of the enemies scales perfectly with your characters. So you don't ever reach that point where you hit, like, you know, that thing that happens in RPGs where, like, you get to a point where you're, like, stuck, you can't beat it, and then you spend, like, a half hour or an hour grinding, and then you go back to the boss, you're stronger, and then it's, like, satisfying to, like, see how much you've improved, and how much stronger you've gotten and whatnot, and then you finally get the victory, and it feels, like, more satisfying because you actually had to, what do you call it, you had to delay that victory or whatever so that it's more satisfying when it actually comes. And yeah, the story didn't make a lot of sense. It wasn't super terrible bad, but a lot of the translation I think was weird. And I don't know, I hold Square to, like, a higher standard. I do like the art a lot, but I mean, Square can write fucking badass killer stories, man. Like, if this game came out after Final Fantasy VI, you know, I was kind of expecting the story to be on par with that level of storytelling and whatnot. There wasn't a lot of them, like, showing the events in the story, I feel. Like when Kefka comes to a town, like, during his, like, rise to power, he has that, like, 5-minute scene where, like, the Espers are, like, fighting him, and it's like showing that he's, like, getting stronger the more Espers he collects. You remember that scene, right? Where he shoots out the thing and it turns him into Magicite. And then he collects them or whatever, and then, like, some of the Espers are, like, trying to, like, take him out. And it's, like, showing that he's, like, becoming, like, too strong and nothing can stop him and whatnot. So, I mean, like, scenes like that, I mean, on the one hand, people don't like it. They're just like, oh, I can't skip this or whatever. But, like, that actually is important for the storytelling. And I feel like because of the sprites, there weren't that many, like, scenes where, like, things were happening. And this, the sprites were too small to show a lot of, like facial expressions. And they didn't have, they tried to give them all, each their own personalities and stuff. But the thing is that the fights took so long that when you would come back to the shipmobile or whatever, when I would talk to the people, they would say something, and I wouldn't know what they were talking about. I was like, is this just a weird line of text, or does this pertain to something that they said, like, last time? Like, sometimes there'll be, like, continuations. Like, you'll talk to someone, they'll say something, you do a battle, and then you come back after the battle, they'll say something that related to the thing they said previously, but so much time passed in between that I don't know, I don't remember if that's the case or not. Especially with me playing, just a little bit at a time over a long period of time. So, actually, I was not able to really, like, enjoy those sections of dialogue or whatever. And yeah, the difficulty was kind of easy. We had too many opportunities to heal. Basically, the battles became really formulaic. Pretty much for the entire game. You just summon, and then you just attack, and then your mages attack, and then your other dudes, your melee dudes, walk up and attack, and then when they get hurt, you know, you just heal, and it's too easy to heal with, like, by going into the party menu. I think I said that this episode. It's too easy to heal in the party menu without even using your turn, and then you can still attack. So, I mean, I guess I would rather have it be that way than to, like, get a bunch of game overs and have to keep replaying shit over and over again, I suppose. Hey, it's the Chrono Trigger area with a red carpet from the Ocean Palace. I do like that, this background or whatever, that little scene. But too many of the dragons could just heal, so I was hardly, there were hardly any time, I think there was one, or I think I got, what, two game overs? But there weren't really that many times where, like, I was in danger of, like, losing. There was that one time a couple battles ago that was a really interesting battle. But that was, like, at the end of the game, and there were hardly any situations like that. You just walk up, and you just, like, wreck ship. Like, it's basically a large part of the game was just me walking towards the enemies, and then once I get there, I just, like, steamroll them. So, maybe... Oh, wait, shit. We got X-Play? What the hell is that? I almost tipped over the mic, by the way. I'm using a blue snowball mic for now, but it's really heavy, so I'm using, like, a mic stand that, like, it goes up and then it tilts 90 degrees to the left or whatever. So there's a lot of weight that's, like, far away from the vertical part of the mic or whatever. So if I accidentally tilt it, it'll tilt way over to where it might actually look like it might tip over. What happens if we do this? Can I skip this? God damn it, I can't skip it. Okay. I'm gonna go on a limb and say it's maybe just harder this time around. Oh, yes, we're not doing a second playthrough of this. Okay, so anyway, that's going to do it for this game. Please subscribe if you haven't already. I like to make videos on the YouTubes here every day, 7 days a week. I mean, sometimes I skip a day, but for the most part, I put up at least one video every day for the most part. Yeah, I do change up my schedule sometimes, so if I say that I do a specific schedule, then if that ends up not being the case, if you watch this video, like, a year from now or something... But I'm doing the grind, putting the videos up every day, so feel free to check out my shit. And thanks guys as always for watching, and we'll see you folks in the next game. Have yourselves a great day. Bye-bye.